All right, everybody, let me give you a real true open that you can have. First of all, hello. Hello, Alabama. Yeah. How cool is Rickwood Stadium? Man, I'm impressed. This is my first time in Alabama, in Birmingham in particular, so this is really a cool occasion for me. My name is Harold Reynolds. You may see me on MLB Network. And so I get to host and MC this event today. I'm truly thrilled. A little baseball thing for you real quick off the top. Today is April 3rd, 2023, but in August 3rd. See, thank you, everybody. August. That's good, you're listening. It's August 3rd. In 1948, Satchel Paige made his major league debut today. How cool is that? All right, so we're lined up. All right, let me get started here. Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to historic Rickwood Field. You know, there's been over 250 players in the Hall of Fame, and about 180 of them played or coached in this ballpark. So it's pretty cool, their connection to baseball. It's known as America's oldest ballpark, but that only tells part of the story. Cool Papa Bell, Roy Campanella, Oscar Charleston. You know what they used to say about Oscar Charleston? He was such a great player that when Willie Mays was coming along, they said, wow, Willie Mays got a chance to be the next Oscar Charleston. That's how good Oscar Charleston was. Larry Dolby, obviously he broke the color barrier in the American League. Josh Gibson, the great home run hitter. Ron Teasley, Monty Irvin, Buck Leonard, Satchel Paige, who I just talked about, Hank Aaron, Willie Mays. Ton of legends have played in this park, so let's give them a hand for that. The history here at Rickwood is unmatched by all the venues in sports, and today we're here to talk about the next phase of this legacy. On June 20th, 2024, the first ever regular season Major League Baseball game at Rickwood Field will be played between the St. Louis Cardinals and the San Francisco Giants. Give me a hand! And the game, of course, is a symbolic celebration of the Negro Leagues and its greatest living player, Willie Mays. Now, before we proceed, I'll give you a little bit of a history lesson, what I've already added to it anyway. Rickwood Field was the home of the Birmingham Black Barons of the Negro Leagues from 1924 through 1960. In 1931, about 15 minutes west of here, Willie Howard Mays Jr. was born in Westfield, Alabama. Come on now. Now, as a 17-year-old, Mays began his professional baseball career with his hometown Black Barons in 1948. That year, Rickwood Field was the site of the final Negro League World Series game, October 1948, which saw Mays' Black Barons fall to the Homestead Grays in five games. The Homestead Grays had Buck Leonard, the Hall of Famer, on that team. Now, if you don't know about the Homestead Grays, they're probably the greatest Negro team, league team ever assembled. These are all Hall of Famers who played for that team, not in 48, but through the years with the Homestead Grays. Cool Papa Bell, Ray Brown, Oscar Charleston, Josh Gibson, Judy Johnson, Willie Wells, Smokey Joe Williams, and Jed Wilson all played in the Homestead Grays system. Pretty cool stuff. Well, one of the great things I get to do is meet people along the way. And I can remember when I was first signed, I'm playing instructional league, and Willie Mays is teaching Chili Davis how to play center field. So you know what we all did? Forget practice. We sprinted out to go meet Willie Mays. And since that time, I've had a real close relationship with Willie. So knowing that I was coming to Alabama, and knowing he's from home, so called him last night, and he sent a text message for all of you, and tell you what this means to him. So let me grab my phone real quick. Here's Willie in his 90s sending text messages. I hope I can do that. All right. Here's what Willie had to say. I was very happy to hear the Giants and Cardinals will play a Major League Baseball game at Rickwood Field next season. I have wonderful memories of playing there with the Black Birmingham Barons when I was only a kid, which, if you can believe it, was 75 years ago. I hope that the game will be a chance to remember so many really good ball players from the Negro Leagues who played at Rickwood Field but never got a chance to play in the big leagues. Harold, you better do your job. That's how Willie Ross said. Willie Mays. Special man. All right. So all that said, without further ado, let's begin our program with our first speaker. It's most fitting to speak on Willie and Rickwood Field's home here in the Magic City. It's my pleasure to introduce Mayor of Birmingham. Please welcome Randall Woodfin. Now I got to put a limit on them. You know how these guys can be, politicians. You got it. Go ahead.
I'll make it quick.
No, you got it.
First, let me say good afternoon to everybody. It's good to be here, and I'm glad that rain doesn't stop the show. With that said, I want to acknowledge County Commissioner Sheila Tyson, who I see to my left, your right, as well as any city councilors that are present. To jump in, I want to state that the Negro League produced champions in more ways than one. Every single black athlete who has ever had the honor of picking up a bat and competing among the best athletes in the world owes a debt of gratitude to the legends who made history when the world attempted to deny them. Those legends made that history right at our own Rickwood Field, everybody, where the Birmingham Black Barons became literal game changers, cementing the Negro Leagues, as well as giants like Willie Mays, as icons of the sport, and icons in the world of social progress as well. That's why Birmingham is so honored. We are excited. President Knight, I see you. We are excited to host the Cardinals and Giants for special regular season games on June 20th of next year, 2024. It has been stated, but it is worth repeating, that Rickwood Field is hallowed ground, where sports became more than entertainment. It was a source of empowerment. And that's what this game represents next year. Progress, power, and my favorite, pride. In a city that exemplified those terms. So I want to say to everybody that is present this afternoon that we can't wait to welcome the Cardinals, the Giants, as well as the entire world to Birmingham. On the same field where the victories came in two forms, both winning in games and chipping away at the barriers that block black athletes from the recognition they deserve. So it's time to make history again. And for the black athletes who paved the way for us to be here today, I have just two words, and no, it's not play ball, but simply instead, thank you.
You guys are fortunate to have him. Another hand for the mayor, please. That was outstanding. Outstanding. Well, for being the oldest ballpark in the country, Rickwood Field sure looks pretty great, didn't it? Before it started raining. Still looks good. That doesn't happen magically. It takes a meticulous steward to maintain the history and upkeep. And our next speaker is that steward. Please welcome the chairman of the board of Friends of Rickwood, Gerald Watkins, my good friend Gerald.
Now, about 2 weeks ago, I was in Cooperstown, New York, and I had a chance to see this gentleman walk off the stage, and I said, I've got to go say hello to him. So I said hello to Harold, and I said, I'm at Rickwood Field in Birmingham, and he said, you know, I may be coming down there in a couple of weeks, and that was news to me. So I said, great, I can't wait to see you, and Harold, thank you. I'm so glad you're here. I've been given 3 minutes. I asked for 3 hours, but it's August in Alabama, and even though the rain cooled it off, I'm only going to take the 3 minutes I was allotted, and I want to start off by thanking people. And mainly I want to thank Mayor Woodfin and his staff, the city council, and all the people with the city who have made this dream a reality. Mayor Woodfin believed in us when no one else did, and we're here because of Mayor Woodfin and his vision. He was a friend of Rickwood before anybody else, and I want to thank you again, Mayor Woodfin. most of my time up here, I'm going to take thanking people, and I want to thank Commissioner Tyson with the County Commission. I want to thank all the county commissioners who couldn't be here. Again, this is a team effort. We've got business leaders here who have volunteered to help with the refurbishing of the ballpark. We have wealthy individuals who have chipped in a coin here and there. We've got a lot of people to thank. So this did not happen by accident. We've been working on this for a while, and here we are. And I also want to thank some very special people who don't get a lot of recognition, but my grounds crew, right up here, raise your hand, guys. These guys have my back in more ways than one, and every time I open the doors in here and I see them here, I feel good about what's going to happen that day. You know, we talked about how many Hall of Famers have played here. There have been a bunch. We named Willie Mays. We named Satchel Paige. We talked about Jackie Robinson. And then there's been Mickey Mantle, and there's been Babe Ruth. And one of my favorites, Reggie Jackson. All these people played here, and they created great, great memories for Birmingham and for baseball fans. But the next great memory is less than a year away. So when we have this Giants and Cardinals game next year on June the 20th, in my mind, that's going to be the second greatest day in the history of Rickwood Field, second only to the day the ballpark was opened. So again, this is just an incredible time, and a lot of people have pitched in to make this happen. And it's just, it's overwhelming to get a chance to be up here and talk to you. I want to thank MLB and all the folks who have pitched in over the last year, who have been so sensitive to our history. They know we have to make changes, but they've been trying to make this so that it doesn't affect the historical nature of the ballpark. And I thank them. That's MLB, that's BAM, that's Populous, and Brightview. Let's give them a hand. And some other folks who are what we call friends of Rickwood. I can't leave out the Birmingham Barons. The Logan family, they jumped in and helped us with some of our fundraising efforts. My good friend Jonathan Nelson, we've been friends for a long time. Jonathan runs the Barons. We're so delighted that these changes to Rickwood are going to make this MLB game happen, but they're also going to bring back the Rickwood Classic, which was a 25-year tradition that we had to stop because of COVID and some other things. But now we're going to have that back. So not only are we going to have this MLB game next year, we're going to get our Rickwood Classic back, and that's going to go on for on and on and on. So great, great things are happening because the MLB listened and came to Rickwood Field. And the last thing I want to do is pay tribute to someone who's not here. I was here one August. Another guy was here, Ben Powell, and our staff. We were here just working around the park. And some members of the Mississippi Braves came in, and they were led by one of their coaches named Doug Mancellino. And Doug and I were talking, and he said, "You need to have a Field of Dreams type game here." And I said, "I'd love to do that. I've been making some phone calls, but I can't get to the right person." And he said, "Let me help you." So he called a few people at MLB, and the next thing you know, I get an email from Jeremiah. He says, "Well, we'll come see your park." I said, "Come on." They brought about a dozen people down here. I said, "Gosh, I got to go call the mayor." He said, no, let us tell him. This is big. This is kind of our thing. We'll tell the mayor." And I said, "That's okay. Let's just get it done." So we all get together over time. We bring this event together. MLB and all its associated folks have been so great helping us. The city, the county, some of our big companies, Regions Bank, Alabama Power, Blue Cross, Encompass, and many, many more are going to jump on board. We have had so much of an outpouring of help that it's just awe-inspiring. And the last thing I can say before I let you go and turn it over, I think I've gone over my 3 minutes, Harold. Right. Okay. If you walk through the turnstiles, walk out on the field, walk anywhere in this hallowed ground, and you don't feel chill bumps, then maybe your heart's not beating. I hope all of you will come back next year. If you don't come back to the game, come back in the meantime. You can take a tour. We'll tell you all about Rickwood and the people who have been here and the people who are here and the people who are coming. It's a great event, and I just want to thank again everybody for their participation in making this come about. And God bless you all. And that's done.
Thank you, Gerald. And also, Mayor, thank you. You know, when he was saying, "I'm over my 3 minutes," and then he said, "hollow ground," I remember growing up in church and my grandmother saying, "You're going to be here for a little while." I go, "Grandma, we've already been here 2 hours. This is hollow ground, honey." So when he said hollow ground, "Oh, Lord, he's going to speak for 3 hours." So you're good, Gerald. Just came way underneath that, way under it. Hey, it's been a busy year for Major League Baseball so far. And on the event space, MLB has led successful campaigns in Mexico City. You may have saw those games. London, Seattle for All-Star Week. How many of you saw that HBCU game Ken Griffey Jr. put on? All right, that was in Seattle. It was awesome. Jackie Robinson Day, Lou Gehrig Day. We're successful across the league, and we got Roberto Clemente Day coming up. And the thing about those three, with Jackie, Lou, and Roberto, they all play here at this ballpark. So pretty cool nugget. And then we start this week with the year started the Dream Series, continued the Breakthrough Series onto the Hank Aaron Invitational, and now the RBI World Series being played as we speak at the Jackie Robinson Complex in Vero Beach. So doing a lot of things to get some things done. Not to mention it's been a transformable year for the league with new rules. How do you like the new rules? Kind of nice to watch a game and have it only be 2.5 hours. Cut off a half an hour on games. Attendance is going through the roof. We had the biggest attendance in the month of July in over a decade. And we are ahead of pace in over a decade in attendance in baseball. So the rules are definitely working. It's been really impressive to do that. The reason I bring all that up, our next speaker, he sits at the table. All those rules, you're talking about the Field of Dreams games, talking about different things that are happening. This guy's one of the top executives in baseball. He was a former college football player at Harvard, played some baseball there too, and he was an architect for the Florida Marlins for many years, and now he's working as a senior vice president of on-field operations. I'm talking about Mr. Mike Hill. Here he comes. Mike. He got into the executive mode and put on a jacket. Let's see.
I didn't know who he was talking about at first, but no, it's... It is my pleasure to be with everyone here today. And on behalf of Commissioner Manfred and Major League Baseball, it's an honor to be here on the hallowed grounds of Rickwood Field. You know, I got here early and I got the opportunity to just walk around. You know, I've been to Birmingham many times. My car lands in Birmingham and immediately goes straight to barbecue. So I did the same thing today, but I did get here early because I just wanted to soak it up and just soak up the history and all the people. We heard about it. 180 Hall of Famers have walked through these fences. And to think that, you know, I'm standing here because of all the sacrifices that they made to make that possible. So to think that next June 20th, we're going to be here to celebrate that is humbling. It really is. To think about what has happened, you know, throughout the years and what has happened within these walls, it truly is humbling. And to echo what the mayor said, it truly will be a celebration because it gives us an opportunity to give voices to all of those people who were unheard for so many years. And to just bring visibility to such a special place. So I'm excited to be a part of it and to know that with the help of so many people, and I don't want to go any further without thanking the mayor and the city of Birmingham, the Friends of Rickwood. There's so many people who we have to thank to know that this is going to be a possibility. So I want to thank all of them for their efforts in bringing this and making this a reality. And I can't wait until June 20th when we're back here and we've got the Cardinals and we've got the Giants running around on a beautiful field that captures, you know, all the modern, you know, amenities that we have going on. Harold mentioned the new rules and everything. We're going to have our pitch clocks and we're going to have everything else going on, but you're still going to feel the authenticity of Rickwood Field. And that is what, you know, we're excited for the world to see and for to be on display for the world. At this time, it's my honor and pleasure. Is Mayor doing this with me?
I'm doing it. Okay. Yeah. Hold on one second, guys. Media, I'm going to give you a minute since we're not out on the field. Kind of reshift your cameras if you need to. All right? Because we're going to unveil a logo right over here, and I know everybody wants to grab this moment. So yeah. I'm going to give you a minute to do that, then we'll get us back. All right? Mike. Yeah.
Okay.
Hold on. I'll let you know. And then Mike can take it from there. All right. We're not doing it yet.
All right.
Hold on. Hey, what happened to the lights? All right. Okay, I'm going to give you guys 30 seconds to get yourself ready. All right. I'm only doing this because I know it's important to capture the moment. All right, I'm going to turn it over to Mike Hill. Go ahead, Mike.
It's my distinct honor and pleasure to announce that on June 20th, 2024, we will have MLB at Rickwood Field, a tribute to the Negro League.
That's awesome, awesome. While y'all taking photos, let me give you a few notes. You two can stand up there. Gerald, where you at, man? Gerald, can't even see you. You getting in here? Come on. In the pictures. You can see some of the stuff around here. All right. A few notes on the event name and logo while you transition to the new phase of the ceremony. When deciding on a name, MLB wanted to remain authentic and true to the purpose of why we're doing this. Rickwood Field and the Negro League's rich history are the stage, and the settings with the big leaguers of the Cardinals and the Mays Giants are the stars of the show. The logo's inspiration came from the era and posters that were designed to promote Negro League games. As you see the block letters, that was what they used back in the day. So that's where that comes from, the wood block printing, the popular font of that time, while the black and white are the color codes that were selected to resemble the iconic scoreboard in left field. All right, so that's some of the things right there. Finish your pictures up. I'm going to hop in for a couple myself because I want to have it myself. Come on, Mike. All right, yeah, sounds good. All right. Thank you all. Appreciate it. Okay. All right, thank you. All right, we'll keep it moving. Yeah, we're not done. We got a panel here real quick. We're going to tell you a little bit more. So you can keep getting shots. Thank you, Mayor. Thank you, Gerald. Thank you, Mike Hill.
Amen.
You got it. Before we move on to the next portion, there's several people in the crowd I'd like to recognize. All right, if y'all can keep the comments down while you move, we'll get this in and we're getting it done. This happens one time when you make these historical announcements. So I'll make sure you get it all. First, on June 18th, 2024, Rickwood Field will bring back an annual tradition of minor league baseball. The Birmingham Barons will be playing a special game here. Next year, the Barons will take on the Montgomery Biscuits right here. And so that's on June 18th. Yeah, it's going to be pretty cool. With us today are the owners of the Barons, Jeff Logan, and General Manager and President Jonathan Nelson. Representing the Biscuits is General Manager Mike Murphy. Where are you guys at? They're here. Representing the MLB PA, Vicky. Where you at, Vic? There she is, Vicky Cabrera. Vicky! There she is, the MLB PA. From the Giants, Chief Diversity Officer, Roscoe Maps. Where you at, Roscoe? Right here. From the Cardinals, I don't know if anybody from the Cardinals made it in or not. I'll represent the Cardinals. All right. The Commissioner's Office of Sports and Entertainment in Birmingham, Ruben Perez. Where you at, Ruben? From the Birmingham City Council, President Wayden Alexander. I think you're around her. And District 8 Representative Carol Clark. All right. Former U.S. Senator representing Alabama, Doug Jones. He's here today. Ah, see. Doug, you might win again. That kind of, you might run again, man. This special event will air nationally on Fox. So thank you to all those representing Fox here today. I don't know who else here. But they usually get out in front of it and they throw these tremendous games as you watch enough games on Fox, so thank you for that. And last but not least, I want to welcome everyone here from the National Association of Black Journalists with special recognition to Sherrod Blakely and soon to be a... Blakely? It's Blakely. Yeah, I thought somebody said Blakely. And soon to be inducted into the NABJ Hall of Fame. MLBBro.com founder and longtime baseball writer, Rob Parker. Congratulations, Rob. Man, Rob came to me a few years ago. He's like, bro, I got this idea. I got this idea. Matter of fact, I might have just said it. Bro. MLB bro. It's my man over there. All right, joining me on the stage here is MLB's field and stadium consultant, Murray Cook. Murray, where you at, buddy? All right, we're going to talk about the field real quick, spend some time talking with Murray. You know, when I was in AAA ball back in 1983 in Salt Lake City, I had no idea why our field was so great. And I was like, man, me, Spike Owen, Jim Presley, Alvin Davis, we all played in the big leagues together. And we're like, man, our field was better than AstroTurf in Salt Lake. Well, I didn't know. I was sitting with the maestro who does all these fields everywhere that you see. So, Murray, tell them a little bit about some of the fields that you do, and then I'm asking a few questions, all right?
I appreciate you, folks. It's been a great run with Major League Baseball. I've been working with them a long time. We just finished up in London with the series there, and obviously we're getting ready to go to Williamsport. I just flew in from Seoul, Korea last night. It was a 14-hour flight and got in here to this morning for this, but we're excited to be a part of this event. We're looking to do some really unique things here at the stadium, but keep it authentic all at the same time.
So Murray, when you go into a field like Field of Dreams, it was a movie set. When you go to Williamsport and it was a minor league ballpark, what are some of the things you have to do and what are some of the things that you do to make it major league ready?
Well, first and foremost, we're trying to work towards having a safe and playable surface for the players. And we try and really work with the local groups. We've got a great team with BAM and Populous who are helping us out. We got a great team here working with the city. We got AG Gaston, who's our general contractor that's gonna be heading us up. So we've got a great group that's gonna be putting together a field that's gonna include new dugouts. We're gonna include quite a few things. We're gonna change some distances and dimensions out there just to tweak them here and there. But overall, it's a lot of work, but something we're happy to do.
Last question, how long is the process? How long does it take till the field will be major league ready and looking?
Well, we're gonna start October 23rd and get most of the field done, the dugouts built this fall, and in the spring we're gonna come in and lay this out, similar to what we did the Field of Dreams when we built the field over in Iowa.
All right, Murray, thank you, brother, appreciate it.
All right, buddy, thank you.
All right, thank you. All right, if you guys got a chance to see that field, the Field of Dreams, man, Murray can hook it up.